marine biomass regeneration, which I initiated from Cambridge, but we have four other institutions working with us: University of Southern California, the University in Honolulu, the Hawaii, University of Cape Town, and the Marine Studies Institute at Goa. And each of them has a research vessel, at least one research vessel. Some of them have more than one. And so this consortium is working on the business of greenhouse gas removal at scale, but as well at restocking the marine system of the world, the deep oceans, with fish, marine animals as well, mammals, and also crustaceans. And so what we have with this project is an understanding based on the work of a German scientist, Smetacek, and he published papers from 10 years ago. This is a recent discovery, but I love it. He found if you film a pod of blue whales coming up to the surface of the ocean, the film suddenly gets cloudy as the whales approach the surface. Now, we're aware of watching them from the air that they're taking in a vast amount of air. But what's this cloudiness? They're relieving themselves. Any mammal that is 300 to 500 meters below the surface of the sea has their orifices jammed shut by the high pressure. So when they come up, it's not only for air, it's also to relieve themselves. Now, what that means is all this fertile material is put into the surface of the ocean, which receives sunlight. And the result of that is that within a week, you might have an enormous area, thousands of square kilometers of sea, covered with green material.
Just from the blue whales defecating?
It, yes.
Okay. And that green material is drawing in CO2 from the atmosphere as it grows.
Drawing in CO2, but perhaps more importantly, it's essentially phytoplankton. There's zooplankton as well. And the zooplankton includes krill, which is the food of the whales. The krill goes down 300 to 500 meters down, which is why the whales are down there. So it becomes a biosystem at the surface of the ocean equivalent to a land-based forest. And the result of this is, if you have a large enough area, you might get a quarter of a billion fish there. Why? Because fish eggs, the sea is full of fish eggs, even though it's almost devoid of fish. But an average fish lays 100,000 to 200,000 eggs a year. So what you have is a lot of eggs. And when the larvae hatch, they die unless there's phytoplankton. Every kind of fish needs phytoplankton. Bingo. They all live in that area. So this is a way of restocking the oceans, but I believe a little more than that.
Well, hold on. Isn't the answer we need orders of magnitude more blue whales then?
Yes, exactly. And you've come to my
point.
How
does that happen?
That happens because this is a process by which you increase the krill population as well. And at the moment, there's a very good krill population around the Southern Ocean, around the Antarctic, and also around the Arctic, but not many other parts of the world. The Arabian Sea has a fair bit. Not many other parts of the world have enough krill to sustain a large population. The blue whales are down to probably less than 1% of the population they were at 400 years ago. That was our first oil discovery. Our humanity's first oil discovery was that these whales that live down below the surface of the sea, where it's very cold, have a large amount of blubber to sustain themselves, and that was our first oil. And so we stripped the seas of whales. And the result is that we were taking out this circular process that the whales were essentially responsible for.
So whales were a big part of our carbon sink, as it were?
They were. That's another point. So yes, they were a big part of the carbon sink, but I'm also saying they were part of creating this foodstuff for the fish larvae to create this great population. If we look at the stories of sailors from 400 years ago, they knew that wherever they were traveling in the ocean, they would catch fish. It's not quite like that today. So I think the point I'm making is This is an amazing potential for restoring biomass to the oceans, but at the same time, taking up vast amounts of carbon. How much carbon dioxide do I think we could capture? If we were to put this artificial whale poo, if I can use that phrase, on the surface of the oceans, and let's suppose we did it to 2 to 3% of the deep ocean surface, how much carbon dioxide are we likely to fully sequester? Probably minimally 3 billion tons a year, maybe maximally 12 billion, 13 billion tons a year. So there's no other way of capturing that amount of carbon dioxide and sequestering it. So I do believe that we might have to continue doing this for 40, 50 years, at which point we've got the whale population back up. And as you were saying, we leave the whales to do it. But we need to increase the baleen whales, or the ones with this blubber, we need to increase their population dramatically.